Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Roger with Electronics and Gadgets. If this is the first time here, thanks for stopping by. Please hit the like and subscribe button. If you've been here before, thank you. For the next video, I'd like to discuss all the specs, information, dispel some rumors on SD cards. Specifically, there's three different kinds, three different names as well. Standard SD cards, mini SD cards, or micro SD cards. The micro SD cards are what you'll find in most phones today, and they're basically a removable storage. It's like having a hard drive with nothing spinning. All SD cards, actually short for secure digital, regardless of their size, use one or two small NAND flash memory chips, similar to those found in USB memory sticks and SSDs, and a tiny processor to manage the flow of data and instruction. Like in the photo here, there are three standards for the dimensions, and they are incompatible with each other. In other words, a mini SD card won't work with a micro SD card unless you use the adapter, which I'm showing here. Next, let's go over the four different types of SD cards. The SD memory cards have four SD standards that feature four capacities. The four SD standards are, as it says, an SD for 2 gig and under, SDHC more than 2 gigs and up to 32 gigs, the SDXC, which is more than 32 gigs and up to 2 terabytes, and the SDUC, which is more than 2 terabytes, up to 128 terabytes. There's four types of micro SD cards, same as the standards for the SD cards. You have the micro SD, micro SDHC, micro SDXC, and micro SDUC, as what is shown in the diagram I have here. Next diagram, I want to show the evolution of the SD cards, and to the left column it shows the date from 2000 all the way up to 2020, and it shows the different kind of cards they've had over the years. All SD card performance, speed, and classes use little brass contacts at the end of the device of the card to receive and send information in the form of instruction and data. The interface between the card and the reading device has evolved with each specified reversion. In some cases, the updated system runs faster. The difference between all the interfaces and performance are set out in so-called speed classes, and each one is generally organized by the peak bus throughput, which we'll go over here shortly. Next diagram shows the speed classes. So we have the column of minimum sequential writes, and we have the class 2, 4, 6, and class 10, then UHS class 1 and class 3. These all mean something, which I'm going to be getting to here eventually in another diagram. So bear with me here. This next diagram is the actual bus speed, the speed that's written through, put, and into the device, in and out, the actual speed that it's obtaining. And this last diagram shows all the different types of the SD, the SDUHS, UHS 2, 3, and the SD Express, and shows their throughput and their memory speeds. So finally, what do all these numbers and graphs mean? Well, this is how you decipher the numbers on a micro SD card. So let's see, what we'll do here is we'll go going counterclockwise. The big number, obviously, that's the storage capacity of the card. Okay, they're all gonna have a number there, and that's how much storage you can get on the card. Next, this card is UHS, or ultra high speed. The rating denotes a minimum sequential write speed, A UHS class 3 card has a minimum sequential rate of 30 MBs per second, while a class 1 has at least 10 megs. Okay, so the next number, the 10 in a circle, that's the speed class. Most cards are now all class 10 with a minimum write speed of 10. Other classes include class 4 and a class 6. They're older cards. Next we have A1, that's the application performance class. This rating guarantees most consistent performance while running apps off of the SD card, which is actually what I do. I use an SD card for my cameras and stuff like that, but I primarily use the SD cards, the micro SD cards, as an external storage space. So I kind of want the faster the better for me. And as I said, the A is the application rate. It's denoting A1 rating requires a minimum substantial sequential rate speed of 10 megs per second. Next we have HC, which denotes the type of card. This is the micro SDHC, secure digital high capacity, which goes up to 32 gigs. While, for example, a micro SDXC, secure digital extended capacity, goes up to 2 terabyte. And most the SDXC cards do not work in older card readers meant for micro SDHCs. And the last one we have is the V rating, which is the video speed class. This rating was created in response to the high resolution and high quality 4K recording. The number after the V is the minimum sequential write speed in megabytes. A V30 card writes data at 30 megs and above. This is the graph that I had earlier on in the video. So my final thoughts on all this. When you buy an SD card or a micro SD card, it doesn't come down to which card is the best, but which card is the best for what you're going to do with it. So that's my video on a basic explanation of the micro SD and SD cards and the different numbers on them and what they mean. Again, use for whatever you're going to do, the purpose of your project, then go and buy the card. Don't buy a card that's going to be super fast and you don't need to utilize that because you're going to pay for that. So I hope you found my video to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below. And until next time, I'm out.